Imagine I gave you a 2 BHK or a big house to live in, but you most of the time stay in the balcony keeping the rest of the house maybe for no use, right? It looks weird, right? Well, the same thing also happens with the current. Now, I gave current the whole conductor to flow, but instead of flowing through the whole conductor, utilizing the whole area, it decides to flow through the surface of the conductor or through the skin of the conductor. And that is what we call as the skin effect. Now, this skin effect is definitely very, very crucial when we are transmitting power over a long distance from the generating station to the dispatch stations that we have. And it definitely contributes to the power loss as well. So definitely one of the important effects that we must understand. And in this video, we are going to discuss about what is the skin effect, what are the reasons for that, what are the effects of it on the power system, and how we can mitigate the skin effect in this video. So make sure you watch it till the end. Now let us first start by understanding why the skin effect is generated. So let us start with the basics first as usual. So we know that whenever we pass a current through a conductor, a magnetic field will generate around that. Yeah, that is the basic fundamental thing that we know in electrical engineering, right? Now we absolutely have no problem when we are passing a direct current or a DC through this conductor, because that is going to give us a steady magnetic field. That means the magnetic field is not changing. The current is constant, and as a result, the magnetic field is also constant. No problem here. Well, the problem starts when we give alternating current to this. Now, alternating current is what you will see here on the sine wave. The current is zero, then it will go to the positive peak, then zero, then negative peak, and then zero. That means the current is changing very frequently. And as a result, because of this change in current, the magnetic field that is getting generated around the conductor is also changing based on how the current is changing, right? And this is a problem. Well, in certain cases it is useful, but certain cases, like for this case, it is a problem. Why? Because, now again, coming back to the basics, the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So when a magnetic field, a changing magnetic field is induced, it is definitely gonna induce a electromotive force into that conductor, right? The EMF. And then what happens is this EMF is basically going to oppose the change in current that is happening through this. And this is what we refer to as inductive reactance. We learned about this in the basics of AC circuit playlist. If you're interested in learning about the basics, I'll put a link for it down in the description. You can definitely go and check it out after this video. So this EMF is basically going to oppose the current that is flowing into this conductor, right? You got the sequence how it is happening. Let us repeat it one more time. So first, since we are transmitting an alternating current through a conductor, it is going to create a changing magnetic field. And that changing magnetic field is going to induce an EMF within that conductor. And as a result, this EMF is going to oppose the flow of current that is happening through that conductor, basically the inductive reactance. Clear? And that is where inside the conductor we are creating an opposition. Actually, we are not creating it, but it is getting created. And that is certainly a problem for flow of current. But still, the question is unanswered. Why the current chooses to flow through the surface of the conductor, the skin of the conductor, and why not to the center of the conductor? Let us have clarity on that now. So imagine we have a solid conductor, and here you can see the cross section of this. Now this solid conductor is made up of a thin layers, like example you can see on the screen. And this thin layer, when we pass current through it, then definitely each of the layer is going to carry certain amount of current. And that each layer will be producing its own magnetic field, which will cause an EMF to induce, right? And since this is the center of the conductor, the whatever magnetic field is produced by the center layer will induce EMF into that. Plus, we have another conductor which is next to that, or another layer that is also going to produce its own magnetic field. Well, that will also induce, you know, EMF into this because of the mutual inductance. Similarly, we also have conductor next to it, which is again not the conductor but the layer. So that layer will also again induce an EMF into that. So you are seeing what is happening. In the center, we have a conductor, we have a layer which is going to induce the EMF. Again, next to that, we have another layer that is going to get induced EMF, another layer, EMF, another layer, EMF. So as a result, in the center, there is more opposition. The magnetic field intensity is higher near the center of the conductor. And definitely that is going to offer more opposition to the flow of current. So just like most of us, current will choose the path of least resistance, which it will get from the surface of the conductor only, right? Because to this surface, there is no outer layer of the conductor. So definitely the resistance will be less here. The opposition will be less. So most of the current density will go towards the skin of the conductor or towards the surface of the conductor. And as a result, only that particular portion is being used throughout the conductor. And this phenomena is what we call as the skin effect. Certainly, it's a problematic situation because you see, we have this whole conductor, but current only decides to flow through this surface. And as a result, it is going to reduce our overall cross-section area, which will further increase the resistance of the conductor and the losses further to that. And definitely this skin effect adds to the power loss. Now, what are some of the problems with this skin effect? Let us understand. So the first is the increased resistance because the overall cross-section area of the conductor is reducing, right? We saw only the outer section of the conductor or the surface section is carrying the current. So my resistance is ultimately going to increase. And when the resistance increases, definitely the I square R losses will increase, which will add to the power loss. Now, this power loss may not be very prominent in shorter distance transmission lines or distribution lines, but definitely it is a problem when we are transmitting power over a large distance. Power loss in that case would be huge. Then of course, when the loss increases, the overall efficiency of the transmission line will go down. And this is something that we should definitely be avoiding, right? And then because there is more power loss, it can affect the voltage regulation, right? It is definitely going to increase the impedance of the transmission line. So the power that you're transmitting from the generating end and the power that we are getting at the receiving end, it may have difference, significant amount of difference. So certainly this effect is not what we would like to have in the system. Well, there are solutions to that. What are those? Let us talk on that now. So we saw that this basically, the opposition is basically due to the inductive reactance, right? And we discussed about this in our basics of AC circuit playlist. And therefore, the skin effect will be depending upon the frequency, no doubt about that. Frequency will affect the skin effect significantly. So inductive reaction formula, we know it's 2 pi FL, where F is the frequency, which means this inductive reactance is directly proportional to the frequency. So if you increase the frequency, the opposition will increase. And if you reduce the frequency, the opposition will reduce. And that's the reason why you will see for 50 Hertz frequency, this opposition will be little less compared to the 60 Hertz frequency. In 60 Hertz frequency networks, you will find the skin effects to be more prominent, right? So based on this, what could be the solution? Well, the solution is reduce the frequency to zero. Well, certainly that's not the solution. That is not something we can do, right? So this factor is not going to help us. So then what are another factors? Now, since there is no frequency for a direct current, you will see HVDC is gaining momentum, is gaining popularity now. Because in HVDC, there is no skin effect present. We are utilizing the complete cross-sectional area of the conductor. There is no high resistance, there is no power loss because of the skin effect. Well, the conductor material. Now, some of the material which are, you know, high in permeability will have higher skin effect. For example, iron. Iron's permeability is high, and therefore the skin effect there will be high. Now, permeability in simple terms represents the easiness for magnetic flux to flow into that. I have a dedicated video talking about what is permeability. If you're interested, I'll put a link for it down in the description. Go and check it out after this video. So few material whose permeability is high, those conductors or those material will have high skin effect. So we use something which is not having a very good permeability. Well, example of such conductors could be aluminium or copper, right? Copper can help us, but copper is expensive, and there is high chance that if I install copper on my transmission line, it is going to get stolen, right? So copper is not a solution. Yeah, maybe if you use aluminium, it's gonna help you with skin effect. And that is the reason why you will find most of the transmission lines are made up of aluminium. So this is offering us some sort of solution. Well, there is another point which can help us to reduce skin effect significantly, and that is the shape of the conductor. Now, what we saw in our example is having a solid conductor, and solid shape is one of the most affected shape because of the skin effect. And that is the reason why you will find the transmission lines are never made up of the solid conductors. The solution to that is using a stranded conductor, like you can see on the screen. So small conductors, you know, coupled together. So small amount of current will flow through each of the current conductor, and it will not have a significant skin effect to that. And if you notice, in most of the high voltage substation, 400 kV, 800 kV, they don't use conductors as a bus bar. They use hollow pipes as a bus bar. And that also saves, because only what the thing that you're offering is the surface of that pipe. It's hollow. So, and that is also the reason you will find the transmission lines are made up of ACSR type conductors, small conductor bundled together. That definitely helps us in reducing the skin effect significantly. Clear? So I hope you got the clear idea about what is skin effect, what are the problems that creates in the power system, and what are some of the things that can control this skin effect. Clear? Now, there are another effects in the power system also, like corona effect. I have created a video on that. I've talked about it in one of the dedicated video. If you're interested, you'll find a link for it also down in the description. If you're interested in learning about the basics of AC circuit, that also I'll provide down in the description. Definitely go and check it out. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.